Go.
Dear Rising Dream Theater, how I miss you. It's very hard to be away from a group that has impacted my life a lot. This group has taught me so much. Flashback to my first play many years ago. I was so nervous. One thing I always remember was Ada telling me to think pink, and it helped. And now for every show, that's what I tell myself. So I want to thank Rising Dream for giving me confidence and for helping me turn from a quiet, shy teenager to a polished actress, and for giving me endless joy of being on stage. I love you all.
Okay. She will be in the dark. That scene ends after you will walk over there.
Yes.
Oh, and you're going to be loud, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. So, in the first scene, which is the opening scene, it's Ida, Isidore, Allison, Rhoda, Fabrizio, Jack, Mary, Rose, which is Jasmine,
yeah.
Eugene, Rose, Emily, Ruth, which is Jessica,
yeah.
Thomas, Murdoch, Blair, Charles, Joseph, and the captain. Could you all stand up? Which is basically just about.
Oh, cool. Oh,
come
cool.
Here.
Nope.
Come
on.
Once upon a time, there were three educators who worked with students in the special needs population. One day, they decided to come together and to start a theatre production company. Realising very quickly that performance was not only fun, but could also have a big impact on the daily lives of those who would become involved, it didn't take long before I Can Dream Theatre was born. It seems that the name of the group just fell from the sky, as though the right words just floated into consciousness. The name I Can Dream summed up what everyone was feeling. Yes, you can dream and you can make it happen. Our three educators, who we like to think of as pioneers, started to form their theatre company, bringing together some of their students and also by reaching out into the wider special needs community. And in doing so, they found superstars. They made shows that were funny and musical, and in the process showed people that we all laugh at the same things, we all sing the same songs, and that the possibilities are endless. It's been 10 years since the first cast of I Can Dream Theatre walked onto a stage and performed their first show. Let's take a moment to look back at some of the magic they have given us. Consider this a love letter.
Dear I Can Dream, how do I love thee? I love the actors because we all become great friends. getting together for our rehearsals is always a happy time, and we love to put on great shows.
Dear Ekin Jufia, for 10 years, I am proud to be part of the beautiful field, giving me happiness, dancing, singing, acting the I love. I miss you, everyone. Hug, love, Jesse.
Let's take a look at the facts. In 10 years, I Can Dream Theatre has produced 8 shows. Love Trek The Final Frontier, One Night at the Copacabana, Hannibal the Musical, The Tale of Macbeth-ish, Remembering Titanic, Back to Greece, Dead on the Orient Express, and Saving Marvel. Rehearsals would begin in January and run right through till November, which is when the show would be performed, and then they'd start all over again. We've had 6,000 audience members through our doors attend our shows. Not bad for a group that started from the inside of a classroom. There are countless stories we've heard over the years of audience members who've come in with trepidation, feeling nervous and not knowing really what to expect. But then they've soon become converts and have come back year after year. And if that's not magic, I just don't know what is.
Hey, how you do?
Isaac!
Sorry, Captain.
Are you out of your freaking mind, Bones? Dr. Death himself is making a house call just for you.
The very, very first show, I remember at the end of it, after we performed in front of 500 people, I looked at the cast and I said, there's something here. There's something really powerful here. I saw self-confidence growing. I saw the joy. I really did.
We need to toe the line. Oh, girl!
That's normal.
One of the things that the I Can Dream taught me was to be myself, basically. So that's one of the things I'm very grateful. Also, of course, they're the ones that introduced me into acting.
My favorite I Can Dream theater show would have to be Love Trek, because I got to play a Spock and sing my own solo.
I'm the fly in your suit. Your shoe, I'm the pea beneath your bed, I'm the poop on every head.
I miss you so much. I know it's been hard, but things are gonna change around here. I'm back, and I will never take my daughter for granted again. Will you please forgive me?
I love you.
I love you too.
With Love Trek, all of the elements that make an I Can Dream show were in place. References to pop culture.
Well, it's been building up inside of me for I don't know how long.
Songs that the audience could easily identify, and simple but fun choreography. This winning formula would end up proving to be the can't lose direction that each show would have.
What I Can Dream means to me is a good place to meet new people. I've made new friends there that I get along with very well. It was also a new experience. I have had some minor experience with plays and stuff, but it was mostly my elementary school doing school plays, and I took one drama course during high school, but neither of them were anywhere near as elaborate as this, and it also required a lot more work.
I Can Dream Theater has taught me a lot of things. How to be a team leader, how to be patient, how to be an actor.
Acting is my life. The roles are different for me, and I love them.
Dear I Can Dream Theater, I am very thankful for being with a group of individuals and giving me the confidence to sing, dance, and also act, and also always giving me a great reason to perform in front of an audience. Thank you so much for everything, I Can Dream Theater.
Dear I Can Dream Theater, I've been in love with you since I attended your 2013 performance of One Eye of the Copacabana. I knew you'd bring me good and happy experiences such as reuniting with childhood friends, etc. And I found a group of people who love to sing, dance, and act like I do. So I decided to prepare very well to audition and get accepted, so here I am as a cast member since 2014. Now I was right, ICDT. I feel more confident with a good self-esteem, new friendships, and best of all, we support each other with respect, where a group never gets criticized. Instead, we care for each other. And there you go, ICDT. Thanks for all you brought to me, and happy 10th anniversary. Love, Diego.
I like all the shows. One's my favorite, Copacabana. I was Guido with a family trap. It was funny, I like it.
One Night at the Copacabana takes its inspiration from the Barry Manilow song and is jam-packed with nearly every oldies song you can think of. It was also the first show where you can see that it begins to think a little bit outside of the box. And it's the first show, and actually the only one since, that contains a small flash mob sequence.
For the man. That was so fun to watch being created. It was so fun to see all the pieces come together. And even the final pieces at the end with costumes and whatever just made it all magic. And it was meant to be a fun little production. It was meant to be something that the audience would smile at and enjoy. And they just loved it. It was fun, it was funny, and they were so animated. And it was just so wonderful to see that.
And they want the very same thing.
What? A piece of this club?
No. Just peace.
All these rehearsals and all these shows that we did taught me a lot of valuable lessons. But the most important one that I will never forget was the time I never took constructive criticism well. Every time that I made a mistake, I beat myself up. I was a perfectionist, so I had to make sure that everything had to be perfect. Everything had to be perfect. No, 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 no. And one thing that I Can Dream had taught me was go with the flow. Go with the flow. And even the time it was hard for me to explain the problem, what I did was I just let it out through my piano, my compositions, the singing that we did in those productions, the acting, and so on.
At first, I was very shy and very scared.
Nervous is fine.
That's good, Emmett.
But as the years went by and performing, I became more comfortable with the cast members and more confident in front of large audiences.
What I Can Dream has taught me about myself is that if I tried hard enough, I could be this leading example of going the extra mile.
I remember being nervous at my audition, so I was extremely excited when I aced it and was invited to be a cast member. At my first rehearsal, I felt like I was the new kid on the block. The other members seemed to know each other since most have performed together in a few plays. I mostly kept it myself. With the support, I gained confidence and realized how determined I was to give it my all.
I Can Dream has taught me confidence. It has also taught me not to let people down. Even when I sprained my ankle, I made sure to go to rehearsal because everyone was counting on me. It has also taught me how much I love acting and singing and how good it makes me feel.
I Can Dream has taught me that I can be more confident and I can be more expressive about my feelings and dancing, and that I feel less shy speaking my lines when I'm acting like a character who I'm playing. And I'm very proud of myself that I could do those things. And I'm extremely happy to be part of this awesome group.
I Can Dream Theater changed my life. It got me to sing and dance in front of a crowd. I Can Dream Theater helped me socialize more with my friends. When I first started, I didn't really like going out. But now, I go out to the movies, restaurants, and birthday parties. I Can Dream Theater is a fun and inspiring organization for people like me to create and work in an environment where I am respected and heard.
Hello, this is Joseph Hunt. I'd like to share with people a small message. Dear I Can Dream Theater, thank you for letting me meet new people and have new experiences. I have never considered myself an actor before, but now that I know I'm capable and can perform in front of large crowds, it was a fun experience and something I will remember for the rest of my life. Joe.
Okay, it's opening night. Are you excited?
Yes!
Yes! We're looking forward to it.
Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
Now, when you're looking forward to it, you have to remember all the things that we've taught you and that we've told you. Where to stand, when to come out. Don't do anything on stage you're not supposed to do. You have cues, and do you leave the stage when the lights are on?
No.
No. Wait till they're gone, okay? So there's nothing more we can do. All we can do right now is say you're gonna go out there, you're going to shine like you guys do, and you're going to have a lot of fun doing it. Yes, Sam?
After the second scene, okay?
Oh, no.
It's over.
Yeah.
Yes, do we go off when the lights go down, or do we go off while it's still up?
What were you doing before?
Because before, okay, Philip and I went off of the stage while the lights were still. We were waiting
is
for
that,
it.
Is the second scene where you're giggling at the end?
Yes.
No, stay giggling until the lights go off.
Okay, well,
no, we're not giggling at the end. We're like, oh, girls, they're our sisters.
And then the lights go off. You stay on stage till the lights go off. Okay.
You know what? He was getting used to the lights.
Okay, all right.
Besides that,
okay.
Are we ready?
Yeah!
I didn't hear you. Are we ready?
Yes!
Must we dwell on the same issues all the time? I know. Hannibal is a bad boy. Blah, blah, blah. He eats people. Blah, blah, blah. Oh! Over it!
All right then.
Hannibal the Musical probably has the second sharpest title in the I Can Dream canon. It answers the question, can you find humour when you look at Hannibal Lecter's childhood? The answer is a satirical yes.
Oh boy, you guys give me a headache!
Aww!
Touch me!
I can't!
Try!
You're funny!
You're a pain, come on!
In true Gonzo fashion, this Hannibal ends up being one of the Brady Bunch.
pretty high in the awkward meter. Must be broken.
Leave her alone.
Yeah, it's Sydney's friend.
Is she real? Does she need batteries? Which is it?
So many scenes that I've written, I'm very proud of, and I'm very proud of them, you know, when they've brought these scenes to life. But if I have to choose one, I would say in Hannibal the Musical, the character Fred, in the second half of the show, did a soliloquy.
You were not cut out to be a mother. But you are. You are their mother and my wife. And with love and patience, we can work through this like we always. I don't understand. But what do you mean you don't love me anymore?
This was the first time that we ever tried something like this. It was the first time that a cast member stood on stage alone and basically in a memory told the story of a conversation he had had with his wife.
To them, you will be dead. It's the only way. I don't want them ever to know that you abandoned them.
And that was the beginning. For me, that was seeing that happen and seeing that come to life on stage and the audience response to it. I realized we can go further. We can tap into some more seriousness. We can tap into a little bit more and challenge some cast members who can do that.
But for all of its humor, the show features one of I Can Dream Theatre's absolute show-stopping moments.
It's almost impossible to look back at all the productions and choose only one performance that I still think about fondly. There are so many for so many different reasons. I have to say, anytime Stephen Atme and Paul Baluka sang together, it was just magic. But the one I'm most proud of is the prayer. I pushed those guys so far vocally, and they worked harder than ever. They brought the house down with their rendition. I will always look back on their performances fondly because I'm so proud and honored that I helped create their onstage magic.
Little did we know, when we were both singing high notes during our Italian segment, the people not just cheered, but roared as though the song delivers such a powerful message, a powerful vibe to it. But it was after we finished the song, standing ovation. It will never forget.
Dear I Can Dream, what I like about the group is the fun dance numbers, acting, and the singing. Also the way the show comes together and find a way to have fun and see my friends. My favorite part of I Can Dream is how amazing it feels when the show is all over. It makes me feel proud of how hard I've worked for the final product.
Dear I Can Dream Theater, I would like to thank you for giving me the opportunity to be part of your theater group. I have learned a lot from you guys. I really have fun being in your productions, and I Can Dream taught me just to enjoy it and have fun and be creative and just put a smile on my face. Without I Can Dream Theater, the world would be nothing, and I really love being part of I Can Dream Theater. I Can Dream is my life, and I never ever want to quit, and I want to join forever.
The I Can Dream Theater have taught me how to have confidence in myself and to believe in my abilities.
I Can Dream Theater has taught me to grow more as a performer and to not be nervous. Because of the multiple practices and preparation, I was able to perform with confidence. I Can Dream Theater has also taught me how to accept things while making a commitment.
What I chose as my most favorite I Can Dream show was The Tale of Macbethish.
My favorite I Can Dream show is The Tale of Macbethish.
The Tale of Macbethish.
I really liked my costume in Macbethish.
My favorite I Can Dream Theater show, if I had to say, is The Tale of Macbethish, which I got to watch instead of acting, unfortunately, since I wasn't in the theater yet then to really be able to take part in. Yeah, the show was very nice for me. It was a good, nice mix of drama and comedy, and you really saw it. I saw it really in just the performances, the songs, the musical numbers, and in just the story. And to be very honest, that show was one of the biggest driving factors that really got me, motivated me to even first audition to join the ICD team.
The Tale of Macbeth-ish was all about going even further outside the box. It took the skeleton of the Bard's play and basically went in the other direction completely. Sets were bigger, songs and dances were more expressive, and there was even an original song written for this specific show.
They cannot see the fear I cry, the fear I cry. The walls I built, they stand alone now. The path to truth I'll make my own.
My favorite play is The Tale of Macbeth is, because I act a sort solo as if it's dancing to bring in love. I can't sing very well. I have trouble talking clear. But I love to act and dance.
I was given a more antagonistic role as the character of... I forget my character's name, but... Even though it was a comedic take on it, it was still my first hands-on experience with a Shakespeare work.
Why, Daddy?
Big.
Why? What are you doing here?
You're not supposed to be here.
We played rock, paper, scissors, and you lost.
I don't understand that game.
Me neither.
For God's sakes, Porter, do you believe this?
I didn't really understand it. either.
Ow! What is wrong with you?
You see, it was.
I said, stop running.
Sorry. My bad.
Hunka hunka burning love. The hunka hunka burning love.
I did an opening solo to Michael Jackson's Thriller dance. I did admire him as an artist. Being on stage on my own made me feel confident of what I decided to do.
Confidence, I can perform in front of an audience in spite of my disability. I've met and made new friends. You've taught me I skip a line, don't stop and move on. Thank you for everything you've done for me.
Dear I Can Dream Theater, I love that I get to do Broadway level work. My limits get pushed and out of my comfort zone. I love that I get to be my friends and meet new friends. And we get to learn new things every time. New dance moves, music, reading, and memorizing lines. I enjoy putting on shows that shows the fruits of our labor that our audience and fans love.
I Can Dream teach me not to be shy, to come off myself, to be social.
What I love the most about I Can Dream Theater is the good friends I've met. I love to act, to dance, and to make people laugh. I Can Dream Theater has opened up my life and heart. It is my dream. I'm so proud to be part of this wonderful world. It makes me feel happy.
Max, start reading. Keep reading. Lift your head up a little bit so I can see your face. Don't ever look at me, though. Just look your head. Look around.
Titanic, as my role as Hank Strong, because he's a very strong character and he always gets the girl like me.
The best show we've ever done is Remembering Titanic.
Water by now.
Are you in a hurry?
Charlie, I said friends. That means no touching.
Oh. Sorry.
Remembering Titanic was again developed as a successful follow-up to the creative high from the previous year. It also stands out because this was the first show where all music was played by our full live band, The Dreamers, who've been with us since the beginning.
Don't think lighting the last boilers is a good idea.
Oh, come on. This is the grandest ship in the world. Everybody knows this, and it's already old news. Now, what we want is for people to marvel at its speed.
Girls, we're traveling home up to New York on the most luxurious ship ever created. Isn't it remarkable?
Meh.
Rose, I am your father. No!
If I look at Rose, the fact that she is the leading lady, she stands out. What also makes this role special to me was when I saw the movie Titanic, a part of me wanted to be her, to live the role. I remember the scene where Jack makes this sweet gesture and he said, "You're never alone, Rose." And I said, "Goodness, Mr. Dawson, you're going to make me blush."
It's all so familiar. Oh my God. I remember now. We died in bed together with your arms around me while the water surrounded us.
You held my hand as I died, so I wouldn't be scared.
I died going down with the ship, like every respectable captain should do.
Now go up
For better or worse, and still thereafter. I died trying to protect you from the water.
And you made sure I wasn't alone.
You kicked me in the face before I died!
You deserved it. We've all been here before. It's already happened. There's nothing to be afraid of anymore. No more pain, no more fear. It's okay now. We're all safe.
Well, we're supposed to bring compassion with confidence and bring peace.
My favorite I Can Dream show that I'm going to choose is Back to Roost because I loved performing the songs from that movie and pretending to be a Rydell cheerleader.
My favorite show is Back to Greece because I loved playing as Frenchie and I liked having a lot of lines and wearing the pink wig.
My favorite I Can Dream theater show is Back to Greece because the movie Greece has been my favorite ever since I was little. I've always wanted to play as Sandy, and seeing all of the singing and dancing makes me wish I was in the movie because being in a musical is so much fun.
If I had a favorite show, it would definitely be Back to Greece because, in my opinion, that had the most authenticity out of all of the shows we've done, given how it incorporates some really complex themes that really got me invested in the story. And it was also interesting to play a character like Danny Zuko, who is the complete opposite of who I am in real life. I mean, taking John Travolta out of the equation, of course. But yeah, it was just, it was really interesting to just get out of that zone. Like, you know, to play somebody like who doesn't have the same personality as me. And that's kind of the essence of what the performing arts is. It's just, is stepping into a new character. And overall, it was just a really fun experience. And Back to the Future and Grease are like the perfect mesh up. And it worked so well. I mean, given the time period and being the 1950s, of course. And the thing is, I've always pictured myself being in a Grease production. And in a way, that kind of did happen. So I'm really happy about that.
Okay, now louder.
Could she get me a friend?
Oh, good, and you're even trying to sing it. Do it again. Could she get me a friend?
Could she get me a friend?
Okay. Ainsley.
Yep.
Tell me more, tell me more.
How much don't any spend?
Okay. And then it's, tell me more, tell me more.
Could she get me a friend?
Back to Greece was not only an ode to two classic films, but it was I Can Dream Theatre's full circle, as an adapted version of Greece was the first production that some of the creative directors were part of over a decade earlier. The cast loved working on this show because the songs in it are so popular and so well known.
We've talked about it for a couple of years of somehow bringing this group from where it started to where it is now and coming full circle with it. So we thought it would be fun to do something, not the same story that we did, because we did an adaptation of the movie. I mean, these guys have evolved so much with their singing and their dancing and their acting. We thought we could really put on something really fabulous. So that's how it all came about, and makes us feel it's that circle.
For Doc, we are planning something.
Oh, I can't tell you.
McFly, what are you doing?
My favorite play was Back to Greece because I had a dance role and I love dancing.
Fun I've ever had with a line was in Back to Greece with the like overly complicated modern Starbucks coffee order.
Yes, of course. I would absolutely love a decaf mocha latte, light roast with soy milk, please. My stomach and dairy don't mix well these days. Oh, and what the heck, sprinkle some chocolate on top.
I'm sorry. What?
In Greece, I was more of a plot-driven device, which was substantial on its own, but I felt like I didn't have that much impact to the story, which might have been the point.
You're married to Frenchie? Oh, never saw that coming.
But yes, my wife is Frenchie. Yours is Rizzo. What are we doing here, people? Dog, did you give them one of your funny pills again?
I get to read scripts, dance, sing, wear costumes, and spend time with the cast and friends. I love celebrating cast birthdays, going to the restaurant, and bowling with ICD gang. We even got to go to New York all together. I am happy to be part of the ICD theater.
I really like Dead on the Orient Express because I was able to be funny and use a lot of comedy, and I really enjoyed it because I just really make like making people laugh.
My favorite I Can Dream Theater show is Dead on the Orient Express because I really like it that there's a whole mystery about finding out who the killer is and by searching some evidence to show proof.
From a storyline perspective, my favorite play is Dead on the Orient Express, since it is a parody of the Agatha Christie novel Murder on the Orient Express, and she is my favorite mystery writer. I have read several of her books and finished them. In fact, I have several on my shelf right now. Let's take a look.
Well, Dead on the Orient Express. So I play the role of Bruce Wayne. This one looks interesting, of a mystery.
I did Dead on the Express, I played the maid, the quiet one.
My favorite I Can Dream Theater show is Dead on the Orient Express because it was my first show with the group, which makes it more special to me. I love that I got a chance to act and dance with everyone.
Dead on the Orient Express may share a similar name to the Agatha Christie novel, but that's really where the similarities end. Once again, this show thought outside of what had been done before and really allowed the audience to be involved. The theatre space was used differently, and audience expectations for a regular I Can Dream show were turned on its head, with a big reveal at the end.
I also love it when Abbott and Costello were arguing about who's on first base routine. That was hilarious.
My favorite I Can Dream Theater show, it was Dead on Orient Express. My part with Maxi was Abbott and Costello because I was so funny. Make the audience laugh, so makes me feel happy.
I was Abbott, and my good friend Mitchell was Costello, and we had so much fun doing our sketch together.
Costello, are you still playing for the team this year?
As a newbie. Hey, Abbott, if you are the coach, you must know all the players.
Right, I certainly do.
I never met the guys. Can you tell me their names so I know who's playing on the team?
Well, let's see. We have... Who's on first? What's on second? And I don't know who's on third.
That's what I want to find out.
I say, who's on first? What's on second, and I don't know who's on third.
Are you that Madison?
Yes.
You're going to be the coach too?
Yes.
And you don't know the final names?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the final name.
Who?
The guy first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who's on first?
I'm asking you, who's on first?
That's that man's name.
That's whose name?
Yep.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's it?
Guess who?
Yep. Right.
You have it out for you, right?
Sure.
Let them first name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask you.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
Then tell me who's playing in left field.
No, who's playing first?
No, no, no. Stay in the outfield. I want to know what's the guy's name in left field.
No, what's on second?
I'm not asking who's on second.
No. No, who's playing first?
I don't know.
Third base.
Around, fella, and you might get a chance to see more.
Oh!
Dead on the Orient Express
That set came in on dress rehearsal. It took several people several hours to put it together and then move it onto stage. And when the cast came in and saw that set, I was a little concerned because I was like, oh my God, what was I thinking? This is massive. And it was like that set had been there for 9 months without missing a beat. They were like the true actors that they are, performers that they are. They rocked that set like it had been there for 9 months.
It also featured another extremely memorable moment of the show, where cast members got to dance with a family member to Crowded House's song Don't Dream It's Over, sung beautifully by Fareed Gull, another former cast member of I Can Dream Theatre.
Don't Dream It's Over came to me at our auditions in 2017. One of the individuals auditioning had the perfect voice for that song, and the song was chosen in my mind on that day. I really don't know how the idea of parents dancing with their children came to me. It just did. I approached many parents of cast members, and those that wanted to do it were in the dance. The parents were invited to our first rehearsal in January 2018, and we began the process. We rehearsed the dance for 9 months. I think the cast members learned it faster than their parents and remembered it longer. They were, after all, used to the process. Parents took videos and worked very hard. They were very committed to the project. It was an opportunity for them to see how hard their children worked to put on a show. I think it was a good experience for all of them. The song almost didn't come to fruition because the lead singer for who the song was chosen ended up not being able to be in the show. Usually we just take out a song or dance if it's not working, but we couldn't do it with Don't Dream It's Over. This performance was going to be too special. Fareed aced the song that was undoubtedly one of the highlights of Dead on the Orient Express. The comments afterward were even more than what I could hope for. I was so proud and touched watching it live, even though I had watched it for 9 months over and over and over. And absolutely to this day, it's one of my most treasured I Can Dream Theater moments.
I Can Dream Theater taught me to develop my skills that I need, meeting new people, developing my friendship, and also singing, because I love music.
I know that I have friends who support me, and that I love I Can Dream Theater. I speak on the behalf of the entire group, a fine professional group of actors. It's been an honor working with you on this project. And all I want to say is thanks.
Dear I Can Dream Theater,
I would like to say thank you for such a ride of exciting theater, interesting stories on stage, and thank you for giving me the opportunity and gift of joining you. Each and every day, I think about how much of a pleasure and adventure it is to practice becoming a character on stage and being the character along with other fellow actors, and to bring joy and storytelling to audiences.
My favorite show was Saving Marvel because I played Sneezy from Snow White.
My favorite I Can Dream production was called Saving Marvel because I got to play Cruella DeVille.
My favorite show is Saving Marvel because I love old music.
My favorite I Can Dream show would probably have to be Saving Marvel. I know, because I was in it.
My favorite I Can Dream theater show is Saving Marvel because I was in a lot of scenes, I was in a lot of dances, and I got to play Doc from Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Saving Marvel was a show that many of the cast members got really excited about. They had asked for a superhero show for years.
Does it include us being superheroes or something?
Captain America?
But when they found out that it was actually happening, they were really happy. Always aiming to surprise, the music in the show only came from Motown, which made for a funny contrast for the audience.
I'm
my favorite lines were, "Come on, Pokesy and Mooksy.
Where are you, my darling?
Don't run away from Mama.
I just want to hug you
tightly.
Heroes, reveal yourselves.
There we go.
Moving forward, even if Hulk gives up on us, we won't give up on him or each other. As the chief would have said, together we can triumph, and together we can accomplish anything. We take one day at a time, and respect and honor each other always."
What about loving each other?
Okay, people, this is exhausting. I don't do motivational speeches, in case you haven't noticed. I'm not Captain Frank in America here! Let's just go out and smoke meat.
But we'll do it together!
Together! Yeah, whatever, we'll go eat.
In 10 years, what's been the greatest accomplishment you think I Can Dream Theater has done? It brought together so many people, volunteers, and the creativeness. It created a family. That family, when it transcends onto the stage, to the cast and what they show everybody, and that shows the fun, the joy, the friendship, the eagerness, the way they just want to be there and shine, and they work together. And the friendships that have evolved is unbelievable. And maybe 10 years ago, some of the cast members wouldn't have created friendships with other cast members. But as the time went on, they all became a family.
Dear I Can Dream Theater, I've heard other cast members say that you're like a second family. My experience has been a little different from theirs. I didn't know everyone already when I first joined. But then I thought about it a little more deeply, and I realized that when I auditioned, I was making the choice to become part of the family, and that I am glad for having known you. Before I started going to I Can Dream Theater, I wasn't receiving much help or support from the special needs community. I wasn't really a part of it, nor did I feel like I was allowed to be. But I Can Dream Theater is one of the best parts of that community. I love what an accepting and encouraging environment you are. You push us to step outside of our comfort zone. You give a loudspeaker to those of us too quiet to be heard. You listen patiently and understand when we struggle to get our words out. You've given us an opportunity to get to know one another. I'm grateful to know you and be a part of you. I'm proud to be part of this family.
The road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. I find love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may
can't wait to get on the road again.
On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway, where the best of friends insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. I find love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway, where the best of friends insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way on the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. And I can't wait to get on the road again. And I can't wait to get on the road again. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Ready?
I can't run, I have sandals on!
I close my eyes to let the curtain to see for certain what I thought I knew far, far away. Someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping. Any dream will do. I wore my coat,
I wore my coat
with golden lining, bright colors shining. A flash of light, my golden coat, the runner's sight, the colors faded into darkness. I was left alone. May I return? Ooh.